Very, very good to be with you again. A few thoughts today that might touch your heart and help you to grow. I think it was Meister Eckhart who said that we grow by subtraction, by taking away things, the junk that gets in the way of our holiness and wholeness. He also said, little by little we grow, and boy, is that ever the truth. Yeah. Anything that is worth doing takes a lifetime, and little by little we grow, and boy, that really is indeed the truth. Here's a nice little story from Anthony DeMello in his book, The Heart of the Enlightened. He tells the story of a woman who complained of to a visiting friend that her neighbor was a poor housekeeper. Boy, she's just terrible next door, huh? You should see how dirty her children are in her house. It's almost a disgrace to be living in the same neighborhood as her. Take a look at those clothes she has hung on the line. See the black streaks on the sheets and the towels. The friend walked up to her window and said, "I think the clothes are quite clean." "My dear, the streaks are on your windows." Oh boy, if we could only keep the windows clear and clean, huh? We're so screwed up. We see things through clouded glasses, you know, through hearts that really aren't whole or free, that aren't transformed, and we're goofing everything up. You know, here's a list of people who did that, and it gives you maybe at the end a feel for what it means to be out of balance. Only order really works. You know, peace is the tranquility of right order. When we have right order in our lives, that's order with ourselves, with others, with God, and so on. Things go well. But when we're out of order, we are disordered, you know, and a big mistake when we do that. And you want to make sure that you never mistake control for order. A lot of people have control, but they don't have any order. Or government, they control people, but there's no real order that builds the wholeness in people. Just listen to this list. It really gives you a real feel for people whose lives are out of balance or out of order. In 1923, 9 of the world's most famous financiers met at Chicago's Edgewater Beach Hotel. Financially, they literally held the world by the tail. Anything that money could buy was within their grasp. They were rich, rich, rich. Read their names and the high position each held. Number 1, Charles Schwab, president of the largest steel company. Number 2, Samuel Insull, president of the largest electric utility company. Howard Hobson, number 3, president of the largest gas company. Number 4, Arthur Cutten, the great wheat speculator. Number 5, Richard Whitney, president of the New York Stock Exchange. Number 6, Albert Fall, Secretary of Interior in President Harding's cabinet. Number 7, Leon Frazier, president of the Bank of International Settlements. Number 8, Jesse Livermore, greatest bear on Wall Street. And number 9, Ivan Kruger, head of the world's greatest monopoly. We must admit that this group was a really very prestigious and a group of some of the world's most successful men. People would have been proud to be able to shake their hands and to be say, "I was there." Huh? At least these men had found the secret of making money. Let's see where these men were 25 years later in 1948. Number 1, the president of the largest independent steel company, Charles Schwab, died bankrupt and lived on borrowed money for 5 years before his death. Number 2, the president of the largest utility company, Samuel Insull, died a fugitive from justice, penniless in a foreign land. Number 3, president of the largest gas company, Howard Hobson, went insane. Number 4, the great wheat speculator, Arthur Cutten, died abroad, insolvent, no money. The president of the New York Stock Exchange, Richard Whitney, was released from Sing Sing Penitentiary. Number 6, the member of the president's cabinet, Albert Fall, was pardoned from prison so he could die at home, broke. Number 7, the president of the Bank of International Settlements, Leon Frazier, died a suicide. Number 8, the great bear of Wall Street, Jesse Livermore, committed suicide. Number 9, Ivor Kruger, the great monopoly player, also took his life. So you see, Only the truth really works. Isn't that true, huh? Happiness again tomorrow always depends on doing the truth today. Listen to Romans. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, so that you may judge what is God's will, what is good and pleasing and perfect. There's another little section I'd like to read to you from Matthew. It really speaks the truth in this particular kind of thing. Stop worrying then over questions like what are we to eat, what are we to drink, or what are we to wear. The unbelievers are always running after these things. Let's the examples we just read, huh? Your heavenly Father knows all that you will need. Seek first his kingship over you, his way of holiness, and all these things will be given you besides. Remember, look at the birds in the sky. They do not sow or reap. They gather nothing into their barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more important than they? Which of you, by worrying, can add a moment to his lifespan? Ooh, boy, we're really goofing it up, aren't we? Happiness tomorrow always depends on doing the truth today. Keep me in your thoughts and prayers, and you are certainly in mine. God bless.